reconstructive surgery is a surgery of rebuilding the tissues of the mouth and jaws and face. And this includes the skin of the face, the bone of the jaw, the muscle of the tongue, and the soft tissues in the cheeks and the palate and the floor of the mouth. And these are obviously very complex structures and very important for normal function, for speech and swallow, and for eating, of course, and the importance of having well-supported teeth. And the rebuilding of those structures is very complex and relies on a lot of different techniques, including using patients' own tissues, using artificial tissues. Sometimes it can be very small amounts of reconstruction, for example, to put a dental implant in, or it can be very large surgery, transplanting bone from the leg, for example, after a large tumour resection. And as an oral reconstructive surgeon, I carry out the full range of those surgeries. Oral reconstructive surgery can be required for a very large range of reasons, from something very simple to an infection from a tooth, which causes the bone of the jaw to be lost and would need to be rebuilt, for example, so that an implant can be placed, to more extensive problems such as a jaw cancer or a lip cancer or a tongue cancer, which can require the resection of quite an extensive part of the mouth and jaw, which would require reconstruction, often requiring free flap surgery, where tissue is transplanted from one part of the body to another and relies on microsurgical techniques to rebuild the tissues. If the jaw joint is damaged, either through an accident or a tumour or arthritis, then we employ very detailed CT scans to recreate an artificial joint using 3D printing and computer design of an artificial joint, which can be implanted and used to restore excellent function to the jaw. And that's one of the latest technologies in oral reconstructive surgery. Oral reconstruction uses a very wide range of techniques, and it can range from fairly simple techniques such as bone grafting to rebuild part of the jaw for a dental implant, and that might use the patient's own bone, or it can use artificial bone or demineralized bone matrix. There are other more extensive types of surgeries, and that can include free flap surgery, where tissue is transplanted from elsewhere in the body, and that can be bone or skin or fascia or muscle or a combination of those, and they're moved from one part of the body completely detached and then anastomosed using microsurgery under a microscope to restore the blood supply to those tissues. Other techniques using latest developments in scanning and computer design and printing can build essentially implants to restore the tissues, and that can be orbital floors or jaw joints or parts of the mandible or cheekbones. These can all be manufactured using the unaffected side as a template and using a computer design to create a millimeter perfect implant to rebuild those tissues. The post-op stage in oral reconstructive surgery depends very much on the extent of the surgery. Simple reconstruction, for example, bone grafting, sinus lift, etc., plus or minus a dental implant, can be done as a day case procedure in a office environment like this, and the post-op period will be fairly simple. It'll be sore for a few days, etc. More extensive surgery, free flap surgery, for example, can require a more prolonged stay in hospital, often with some period in intensive care, and anywhere between 5 and 15 days actually in hospital. And during that period of time, it's very intense rehabilitation for the patient. And there's a big input from the other members of the team, including speech and language therapists, physiotherapists and dietitians, to help the patient relearn their normal function in those tissues which have been reconstructed.